Thank you for your interest in the Equitable VMT Mitigation Program study led by VTA. We understand that when development happens in your community, like new housing or new retail buildings, you'll want to understand how it might affect travel. This video explains VMT, or vehicle miles traveled, a measure of the total amount of driving that happens in an area. Recent changes in state law have required cities and counties to use VMT to evaluate new development rather than focusing on delay or congestion. VMT is the distance that a car travels regardless of how many passengers are in the car. So this car, traveling 1 mile, would generate 1 VMT. And 4 vehicles, traveling 10 miles, would generate 40 VMT. To understand how much VMT a person generates on a typical weekday, it's useful to map their travel throughout the day. In this example, Sarah, who lives in a suburban community, starts the day at home, drives to the coffee shop 2 miles away, and then heads to work, which is 10 miles from the coffee shop. After a day at the office, Sarah returns home 11 miles away. Later, Sarah heads out and drives 1 mile to the gas station to fill up before driving another 3 miles to the grocery store, and then makes the 2 mile trip back home. By adding together the miles driven, it is shown that Sarah has generated 29 VMT for the entire day. This VMT can be further identified by the purpose for each trip happening throughout the day. VMT can be organized into 3 typical trip purposes: home to work, or HW, home to other, or HO, and other to other, or OO. The system for categorizing trip types helps us understand that trips to and from work tend to generate the most VMT. We also have learned people are willing to drive longer distances as the benefit of the trip increases. So why does the amount of VMT matter? When we provide more transportation choices for getting around, VMT is reduced. This reduces greenhouse gas emissions and improves community air quality, health, noise pollution, and street safety. Lowering VMT generally improves the quality of life and strengthens the economy, as more space in our communities can be designed for people rather than for cars. For example, let's imagine this street has 6 lanes, a concrete median, narrow sidewalks, limited bus service, and no bike facilities. If we focus on providing more travel options and reducing VMT, we may be able to repurpose some of the street space for a bus lane, widened sidewalks, and a separated bike lane. The widened sidewalk now allows space for trees and outdoor seating. The separated bike lane reduces bike collisions on the road, and the bus lane allows for faster and more reliable bus service. Maria and Anna now feel safer walking to their weekly lunch date. Rose, who is 80 years old, finally feels safe to ride her bicycle with the protected bike lanes and calmer traffic. Juan can now get to work in reasonable time via bus, and there's still space for Gus, who needs to drive to his doctor's appointments. They are getting their different travel needs met, and VMT and emissions have been reduced along the way. New development can contribute to strategies that reduce VMT and improve quality of life for you and for other Santa Clara County residents, workers, and visitors. A VMT mitigation program could help make that happen.